It's an opaque world of covert operations, filled with highly dangerous missions, sometimes to arrest or kill the enemies of Israel.
And there was Ronen, standing with his long silencer gun drawn, not shooting.
And this writing is a rare glimpse inside Mossad, Israel's foreign intelligence agency. It's only fictional, but according to the author, realistic.
The driver, startled. What is similar to reality is the atmosphere in Mossad. How do you prepare for an operation? What is the relationship between the operatives and themselves when they are in an operational unit?
Mishka Ben David is himself a former Mossad agent with intimate knowledge of what the organization has done and how it operates. This is him in 1997 on an ill-fated Mossad mission to assassinate the leader of the Palestinian militant group Hamas. The leader, Khaled Mashal, was poisoned, but the Israeli assassins were captured by Jordanian security. In a highly embarrassing episode for Israel, Ben David was ordered to deliver the antidote, saving the Hamas leader. It's real-life operations like this which inform his work, including his latest novel, Duet in Beirut.
The book starts with a failed assassination, which I placed in Beirut and against the head of terror acts of the Hezbollah. The guy did not pull the trigger because the little girl of the object was there, and the operation failed.
It's the slip-ups of Mossad, it seems, that make the best stories. This infamous operation in Dubai in 2010 saw suspected Israeli agents caught on camera during an operation targeting a Hamas operative in a Dubai hotel. Israel would neither confirm or deny the operation, but an Israeli movie has now been made dramatizing the incident, including the alleged use of stolen foreign passports, which caused international outrage. Ben David's own fictional accounts of operations gone awry are carefully scrutinized by Mossad. The spy agency reads every word, he says, before it goes into print.
And what kind of changes have they asked you to make? Have they vetoed storylines, for instance?
No, they've never vetoed storylines. But in one case, the Mossad asked me to change the make and the color of a car, which I described, because they said we are using just this make and this color.
The books now being published in English are just stories about Israel and its notoriously secretive foreign intelligence arm. But in each one, there may be just a grain of truth. Matthew Chance, CNN Jerusalem.